What's happening, y'all? This is Andrew from Mirror Music, and today we're going to do a non-hip-hop song. I'm going to do Dolly Parton's cover of Let It Be by the Beatles. Dolly Parton is one of the most universally beloved musicians probably that's ever lived. Like, there's no, you can not find anybody to say anything bad about her. The story of this album, she did a bunch of rock covers, is that she was inducted to the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame this past year. And when her nomination came up, she said, "I'm sorry, I'm not like a rock singer. Please, I'm going to respectfully, I appreciate the honor, but I also respectfully decline the nomination." And they told her, you know, that it's not just rock musicians that are in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. There's hip-hop artists, there's jazz musicians, there's, you know, pop stars, whatever. So they said, you know, we are going to nominate you. And she said, okay, then, since I feel like I have to contribute something to this, so I'm going to record an album that's rock and roll covers. She was an Elvis fan when she was younger. She has said that in many interviews. So she says she was going to record an album of rock and roll covers, and everybody's like, okay, cool. And then it comes out, or it's about to come out now, and you look at the track list, and this is not just some, like, rando rock songs that she sort of paid for the rights for. These are, like, some of the biggest songs of all time. She does covers of We Will Rock You and We Are the Champions, Let It Be Here. There's collaborations on here with, not just collaborations with, like, taking their songs, but, like, the artist appearing on the album. This version of the song, Let It Be, features Paul McCartney and Ringo Starr, the two remaining living Beatles, are playing on the song with her. There's one with Steve Perry, the lead singer of Journey. There's one with Rob Halford, the singer of Judas Priest, which is one of the biggest metal bands of all time. There's one with Elton John. I'm forgetting a bunch. There's 30 songs on this record. So that's another indication that she is tremendously and widely respected, even though she's a country singer from down home Appalachia. So I've not heard this whole version of the song before. So this is Let It Be, as sung by Dolly Parton. That's Paul singing with her. Let it be. God, that's so beautiful. Like, one of her gifts, she has many, many gifts, obviously. One of her gifts is that she can take a song and make it her own without, like, ruining your picture of the original song. This is a song, like the original version of that I've heard, you know, thousands of times. But when you hear a cover version of a song, I always want to hear, or when I hear a cover version of a song, I always want to hear something new, right? And doesn't necessarily mean they have to sing the lines differently or over-sing them, which is what happens in lots of covers. People try to superimpose their will on the song and over-sing it. And she doesn't do that. But it's still Let It Be, but it's still Dolly. So far, it's beautiful. And this is not a song that I would have thought of for her to record, but one of her other geniuses is, as soon as you hear her voice, you're like, of course she did the song. It's perfect. And in my hour of darkness, she is standing right in front of me, speaking words of wisdom. I wonder if that's Paul playing the piano, too. I bet it is. And the way she phrases that is a little bit different. She has a very underrated voice, too. Yeah. And also, it's just kind of like Johnny Cash's American series, where he did lots of covers, and he was an older man. And she's not that old. She's in her 70s, I think. There's like a little quaver in their voice a little bit, a little shake. Not, her voice is still amazing, but there's a little age in there. And that little indication of age in the voice doesn't change the meaning of the song necessarily, but it does imbue it with a depth that it didn't have originally. Because, you know, Paul McCartney wrote this song when he was, what, 27, 28, 29 years old. And he's been playing it for, you know, 50 years now. So, yeah, it's beautiful. It's beautiful so far. That's different, too. I wonder if they were like in the room together singing this, or if this is overdubbed. Yeah, I love, she has whisper words of wisdom, and she like actually whispers, "Let it be." Like, that's an interesting twist on the song. I would be really interested to know, and maybe you can tell me in the comments if you know this already, whether they sang this like together in the studio, or they just farmed the track out, like she sang her parts of it and they sent it to Paul and he sang his parts and so forth. I wonder if we're going to hear Ringo's voice too. I assume he's playing the drums. There's a version of Let It Be that has a guitar in it like this, too. It's not the most famous version, but there is one that has it. I wonder who's playing that. You guys know who's playing that? Paul usually doesn't play lead like that. He's probably playing piano. Breakdown is just I always thought of Let It Be as being a more serene, not quite such an arena rock song, but Paul's singing on this like he's singing Hey Jude, which is a big arena rock kind of feeling song, and he's doing his little ad-libs on there. I always thought of this as kind of a peaceful, serene piano song, but it's cool that with her they're opening it up into like a bigger thing as well. That's how he sings Hey Jude at the end, too. You're turning it down now, right? Paul's definitely improvising on that, like he's in the room with them. But obviously, Paul McCartney has sung this song hundreds of thousands of times, I would imagine, at this point in his life. Probably every live show he ever plays from, you know, the 1970s through, you know, now, as he's sung this song. It's one of the greatest rock songs that's ever been. But yeah, it's so cool to hear, just because she put something new to it. It's distinctly Dolly. It's distinctly her. It's got that country-ish feel to it. Anything she puts her voice to has that country-ish feel to it, but it still feels true to the original too. And like, that's so hard to do. It's so hard to do, to accomplish that. But she does. So I'm looking forward to hearing the rest of this album too. Obviously the songs that she's covering are some of the most iconic rock songs of all time. So, shout out to Dolly Parton. I don't know if we call her one of the most underrated musicians, because she is obviously widely respected, but when we think of like the greatest songwriters of the 20th and 21st century, there's not enough people that mention Dolly's name, and she belongs on that, in that conversation. So, we love you, Dolly. Take care of yourself. See y'all next time.